teachable moments. Teachable moment. Little Africa. Let's grow. Let me take you back in time and provide you with some knowledge. See, I'm going to tell you about a place you probably won't hear about while attending college. The time was 1870 to 1921 for your historical notation, and the north side of Tulsa, Oklahoma is the actual recorded location. North Tulsa was called Little Africa, as this name marked praise. The most affluent black community in America, the witnesses were amazed. Jim Crow laws created all black communities. See, we cannot deny this. And write down racial lines for how the United States was divided. Tulsa, Oklahoma was separated by the Arkansas River, but not equaled by any tale. The white side was not nearly as prosperous, while the black community completely excelled. Little Africa had black doctors, politicians, or barons, and PhDs. All black businesses, farms, schools, and many black attorneys, black-owned restaurants, grocery stores, libraries, movie theaters, and places to sleep. So many prosperous businesses that Greenwood Avenue was called Black Wall Street. Yeah, Black Wall Street, because see, that's just how much money flowed. I'm not making this up, it's research, and it's the truth history holds. Nepotism kept the money circulating within the community, even for loans. Everyone purchased from their neighbor, which kept the money coming right back home. Brotherly love and altruism were practiced, while crime was very low. Morals were taught to all, and children, well, they actually did what they were told. Neighbors volunteered to help other neighbors in times of trouble. City families had about 5 children, while farming families had about double. White coal miners came to North Tulsa to work 72-hour long shifts as well. So they too helped the pockets of these black businesses to swell. From Greenwood Avenue to Archer and Pine Streets, life was prosperous and grand. And if you take the first letters of those streets, G-A-P, you will see that is where they got the name for the Gap Band. By 1921, there were over 100 black millionaires, 6 of them even on airplanes. Black Wall Street was thriving and looking for more financial gain. But on the south side, whites lived below the poverty line. And white servicemen returning from World War I, well, they also fell on hard times. So what happened to Little Africa, one might say? Well, the Ku Klux Klan decided they were going to take that prosperity away. So on the 1st of June, 1921, envy, greed, and jealousy took control, and a black Holocaust in America was about to unfold. This race riot was one of the most violent ever carried out on American people. It was the largest massacre of non-military Americans in history with no recorded equal. Within hours, 36 black-owned businesses destroyed, wiped off the town. 3,000 men, women, and children dead. Hundreds could not be found. Hundreds of homes and farms lit up the skies, and they were burned to the ground while good white Christian families just watched and stood around. Witnesses to the KKK killing anyone whose skin color was brown. Little Africa was unlawfully lynched as this massacre went for 72 hours and from yard to yard until the white sheriff sent his black deputy to call out the state's National Guard. The National Guard came to prevent the loss of more innocent lives. As death is what they saw. And the first order of business was to establish and enforce martial law. They stopped the killings, aerial bombings, disarmed and sent the Klan home by doing their job, but they failed to prevent the loss of hundreds of stores, movie theaters, banks, pawn shops, churches, and even a hospital laid in the wake of this hateful and angry mob. Restitutions never happened. Insurance claims dishonored and black voices silenced. Mass graves around the city hid this act of complete and senseless violence. Impacts, African Americans have little nepotism and we seldom support each other. And our money leaves the community within about a couple of hours. So consider this your history lesson for today. And don't underestimate your economic might. Because if you don't honor and protect what you have, it will be gone overnight.